This is my 100th video game I've reviewed on my channel. I wanted to make it a special one to me personally, but the problem was, the first three games that come to mind, King Kong the Game, Army Men RTS, and Prisoner of Azkaban, well, I've already reviewed those. But there is a fourth. There is a fourth game out there that I've yet to review that I played a lot when I was a kid. And that's what we're going to talk about today. This is Hexen for Nintendo 64. Don't go away. So Hexen is a game I've had a pretty long pass with. I've had this game for quite a long time, honestly. The most previous record of me playing it was, well, co-op. Yes, this game features a full campaign split-screen co-op. About 6 or 7 years ago was last time I played it. It was full co-op when I did. And of course, with all the nostalgic games that I played when I was a kid, the question playing them now, in a modern age, is does it hold up? And once again, to my surprise, yes, it holds up extremely well. Now, just by looking at the game, you're already going to be able to tell this is a Doom spin-off. Doom released in 1993 and pretty much birthed an entire genre of games. This game included. But if you look at Hexen and just think it's a Doom clone, you are only skimming just the tiny visual surface. This game is so much more explorative than a Doom game. There's actually a bit of a story here, sort of. It's the hero's journey. At the beginning of the game, you select one of three main characters and you spawn into pretty much hell, and you have to fight your way through Korax's minions all the way until you get to Korax. Along the way, he's taunting you every step of the way.
Worship me, and I may yet be merciful. Then again, maybe not.
Each level you enter shares zero similarities with the one previous. There's new enemies to progress through, there's new bosses. The pacing is really great here. And the way to progress is way more complicated than any Doom game. It's not just find a yellow or a blue key card, find the door, then find the exit. The best way I could describe this is it's like a Resident Evil game.
What are you talking about?
Resident Evil games itself are a puzzle. It's basically one enormous puzzle that you play as the main character, slowly unraveling keys, hidden doors, stuff like that. That's exactly what you're doing here in Hexen. You spawn in, you find hidden doors, you find keys, switches to pull open other hidden doors. You slowly progress through this giant puzzle, basically, while destroying enemies along your way. It's just such a neat bow tie for a great gameplay experience. Weapons are pretty important here because that's what's on screen 100% of the time. And it's safe to say the weapons in Hexen here are outstanding. The weapons for the fighter, okay, they're pretty average. But if you're talking about the mage or the cleric, incredible. The mage has a cool beam staff, a ice hands ability, electric hands ability, and not a great ultimate, but on the cleric side, you have fire hands and you have and his ultimate. Okay, cleric's ultimate, since I played this game when I was like 5, the best weapon I've ever seen in gaming history. To this day it holds up. It's called the Wraith Verge. When triggered, when you fire that button, you click the trigger, it shoots out ghosts. Okay, you literally shoot ghosts out of your gun that haunt the enemies until they die. Just the description of that alone sounds amazing, but you accompany it with the sound effects of the ghost screaming, the hit sound effects. It's incredible. This gun is my favorite gun in history.
Ah!
And there's really not much else here to talk about. This is only a 5 to 6 hour Doom Engine game. There are basically zero drawbacks. One drawback I can see, if I pull back my biasness and experience with this game, if I came in on this game fresh, first blind playthrough, it can be complicated. But I'm not 100% sure on that because I played it when I was a kid and I was confused, but playing as an adult now, I didn't need a guide during this entire playthrough because most of the things seemed quite obvious to me, but that could possibly be because I beat the game before, years before. I could be pulling knowledge out of somewhere that I don't even know exists. And also, this game trolls you in hilarious ways. There are weird secret trap doors and stuff you can fall down to your death, and you have to restart at the main portal of that level. And the main culprit of this is like, okay, you fall, your guy goes, and then you die, so. So I reloaded my previous save. Couldn't find anything in the level for like 10, 15 minutes. I'm like, man, maybe there's something I'm missing. So I went back to that cliff. I fell, I slipped off the edge. I was like, okay, well, I'm not finding anything else. Let me just teleport back to the level. And I landed on a portal to the next level. There's no way you'd be able to tell that anywhere else. Even though I've never personally reviewed this game on my channel, you've maybe heard me talk about it before, because anytime I mention games with great presentation, this is always up there. Up until I listened to the critics and played The Witcher 3, the Hexen for Nintendo 64 was the best presentation a game I've ever seen up to that point. And to this day, in 2023, it's still top 2. In my opinion, soundtracks are a huge reason for that. I'm always an advocate that soundtracks should always be front and present. They're much more of a character than people realize. And I specified the Nintendo 64 version here because the soundtracks are different on PC and other platforms. Listen to the PC soundtrack here. And then listen to the same level on Nintendo 64. And it's not just this soundtrack that makes this game of great presentation. It's that fact that every single level has a new soundtrack and it doesn't miss at all. Enemy design and sound effects are just so variable. Like, Resident Evil 7 gets crapped on because of the enemy variation. It was just the molded. Here, you couldn't find any two enemies that look semi-alike. Every single enemy is so far across the board, it's crazy. Everything from the main little minion dudes to the Ice Age Yeti looking dudes to the dark bishops to the chaos serpents. And accompanying the visual standouts on enemies is the sound effects to come with them. They're great. I'm just gonna let like 10 seconds of the dark bishop come in here because I've never heard an enemy to this day sound similar to him. The different design and look of levels, the look of the water and how it moves, the look of enemies in the water, how lava looks. Caves, I will say, can get some samey, but you still have different looks of caves. And even small details I love it when games make it so that no matter what way you're facing as the player's POV, statues or inanimate objects or dead bodies are facing you. You will never see the backside of a dead enemy in this game or a statue or anything else that you think wouldn't move but is moving. There are such things as brutal or hardcore kills in this game. Killing an enemy, just normal attack with your first, second, or third weapon, we'll just kill him. But use your ultimate weapon like the Wraith Verge or something similar, he will get basically like split in half, explode. So for overall impact, this game's awesome. If you haven't played this game, it is so much fun. The main tagline I stick to this game to this day is it's unique. To this day, still after all this time, I've never played a game as unique as Hexen. Item management is in this game, and it's pretty cool. The items are pretty sick here. You have your basic pink health potions, green flasks, which depending on which character you're using, change. The fighter uses them like hand grenades. The cleric uses them like poison gas clouds. The mage uses them like time bombs. Repulsion discs are cool. Torches are a great example of getting just a basic menu option ability and turning it into a in-game mechanic. Brightness options are almost always available in games, but Hexen made it an ability. It's sometimes dark and sometimes too light in Hexen. Didn't you find yourself in a dark cave? Well, guess what? I've saved up like 2 or 3 torches. Use a torch and the brightness just shoots up. You also have Wings of Wrath to fly, Icon of the Defender, Chaos of Might, Dragon Skin Bracers to boost your armor, Chaos Device to teleport, Dark Servant is my favorite item in the game. It's basically this little plush dude you pick up, but when you throw him out, he like transforms into this giant like 12-foot ox dude who fights by your side. And you get these guys very rarely. Like I think I found like 3 or 4 the entire game. So I'd save them for boss fights and turn it into a 2v1 situation. And speaking of boss fights, still, again, I'm going to say this again here, like for the 10th time for you. To this day, I've never seen this done before. Remember the 3 characters from the starting screen, you get to pick one? Well, those 3 guys, you get to fight them in the end. Right before you fight Korax, the main boss, you have to get through the last gauntlet. He tells you this.
Are you strong enough to face your own master?
And what he means is you have to fight the 3 main characters, a clone of yourself and the other 2 characters you didn't pick. You have to fight them as well. And they're all wielding their ultimate weapon. So if you play as the mage and you're fighting with your bloodlust thing, you have to face the Wraith Verge on the other side, the ghost turned enemies against you. This was such a cool concept. It's crazy, hasn't been done before. A boss being the other characters you didn't pick, that's pretty sweet. And bottom line, Hexen, across the board, unique, fun, rewarding, great puzzles, great boss fights. I don't know how much more I can say on this game. It's 5 to 6 hours long. It's based off the Doom engine, but it's so much more. 9.9 out of 10. So that's it. Hexen from Nintendo 64 down. And that was my 100th video game review, honestly. I will have probably a couple just like celebratory things coming out, pretty short stuff. I'll probably do a top 20 games of all time for me personally. I haven't made a list like that since like 7 years ago or something. And I'll probably do a little commemorative video of like 5 seconds from each of the 100 games that I reviewed. It would be kind of cool to look at. But I have so many games lined up that I'm probably going to hit 200 game reviews sooner than I think. I got the Assassin's Creed. I've got like 6 games I just bought like a week ago on PSN here, and one of them is like a triple pack. I got Nintendo 64 games I want to do. I want to complete the Rare platformer trilogy. I got Conker's Bad Fur Day, DK64. I got Dishonored 2 coming up. There's so many games. Hogwarts Legacy for PS4 is released now. There's so much going on, so I might as well get started on that here. But for now, that's my 100th game review. I'm your host, Sarah Planet Entertainment. I hope you enjoy this video. Peace out.
You have played this game too long, mortal. I think you came from the board.
Yeah. What is up? I know what you're thinking. You're only here for the bonus Easter egg soundtrack I put in at the end of every video. But did you also know I have a donation page under Buy Me a Coffee? Donate whatever you want to my channel and I'll put half of that back to an environmental charity. So that's that. Enjoy the music. Peace out.